I have great expectations for myself. I accept the challenge to become the best student I can be. I am proud of my school. The vision of Oakview is to promote a high-performing culture and climate to inspire our community of learners to achieve academic excellence. I accept this responsibility of my behavior and its results. I am determined to be safe, responsible, productive, and respectful. I have high expectations for myself, and I will reach my full potential. I choose to be great.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Listen up, Oakview Owls. Saturday, October 21st from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock. It is going to be our fall festival. We cannot wait. There's going to be games, crafts, food truck, and more. Pre-sale tickets, $3 per person. On the day of the event, $5 per person. Cash only, please.
Get ready. Oakview Elementary, I'm ready for some kid power. Get ready for our science expo in the month of December. Oakview Elementary, I'm excited to see what you're going to bring. I want you to get ready because we're coming. Bring your science projects out in the month of December 2023. Oakview, be ready. Don't be square because I'm coming for you.
Greetings, family. It's mindfulness time. Put your hands up in the air, slowly wiggle your fingers, clap them together. Now slowly place them in your lap. Bring your shoulders up to your ears as far as they can go. Hold them there. Hold. Now drop them. Relax. Now bring your shoulders back up to your ears. Hold. Now relax. One more time. Bring your shoulders all the way up to your ears. Now slowly relax them down in a relaxed state. Allow your bodies to be still. Allow your voices to be quiet. Your backs are straight. Allow your eyes to close. You may focus on your breath. Continue to focus on your breath. Allow your eyes to open. How do you feel? I hope your shoulders are feeling more relaxed. The area around your neck, your upper back is feeling more relaxed. Sometimes we carry a lot of emotions and tension in those areas. So that exercise with raising your shoulders up to your ears and holding it for at least 10 seconds and then just completely dropping them down helps to release stress that has settled in those areas, okay? And that is a physical exercise that you can do to help release stress out of your body and your mind. We mostly talk about doing mindfulness or meditations or visualizations to help release stress, but we cannot forget the physical part that we need to put in our practice to help release stress out of our bodies. Yeah, so thank you for rocking with me with that part. So this week we've been talking about going out into nature to help release stress and anxiety and to feel more feelings of calm and peace inside of our bodies. Okay, so what have you done? Have you gone outside and watched the trees and the bees? This time of the year, we're starting to see leaves fall, and we're also starting to see the fall foliage. The fall foliage is when the leaves begin to turn colors. We don't have a whole lot of it at this particular time, but they're going to the through the process. And if you do not feel comfortable going outside, again, like I taught in our previous lesson, you can go to your favorite social media site and you can Google nature scenes. You can Google nature, or search, not Google, you can search nature sounds. And you can go anywhere in the world through social media to hear the natural habitat sounds of different areas around the world, and to experience animals, the terrain in any part of the world that you choose to go. And it will help you to feel calm, more relaxed. It takes your mind off of the things that may have been running through your mind throughout the day, okay? So I'm just going to include a short example of what I do at least 3 to 4 times a week at night. Now, I'm not encouraging you to go outside at night if it's not safe or if you're not with an adult or with a partner, but this is something that my husband and I do at least 3 to 4 times a night. We go out and we walk at night and we have a great conversation. And sometimes we don't have conversations. Sometimes we just find peace and walking together at night, being out in nature and spending time with our dog.